All right. Well, if you have your Bibles, let's go ahead and open those up to the book of Revelation. Is there anything better in life than just opening up the Bible and sitting with the Lord? I do hope and pray that you've experienced that. You know, to have a notebook, maybe a little notebook, your Bible, sit before the Lord. You know, whether you're going through a Bible reading plan or just doing these devotions, reading through Revelation or reading through Matthew as we're studying it on Sunday mornings, getting ahead, doing a proverb a day, I find myself when I just stay in the Word and I get in the Word devotionally with an expectation for God to speak to me. And I think expectation is a very important part of walking with the Lord. See, when you're just kind of going through the motions, you're not expecting anything. And I don't know that our ears then are tuned to the voice of God. It's like a radio tuner. You know, you can get close to the station, but it's scratchy, it's fuzzy, it's not really discernible until you get right on that station. And I don't know a place to tune our spiritual ears to God's station that's better than just reading the Word, getting into the Scriptures. So if you have your Bibles, we're going to be in Revelation chapter 9. Revelation chapter 9. We're going to be looking at verses 2 through 4. And we are currently going right through Revelation. We're in the portion of Revelation where we see the seven trumpet judgments of God. Right? God always blows the trumpet. He warns people before he brings judgment. And this is a time of warning, I believe, for humanity. As I teach these devotions, we're still under this coronavirus quarantine order. I do believe that things are getting closer to getting back to normal. But this is a warning. This is God telling man, listen, no matter how good you might think you are, you're not good enough in your own efforts to get to heaven. And I think it's important. We need to realize this. We need to heed that warning. You know, even if you go to church, if you're a Christian, if you still are thinking, I'm going to get to heaven based on my own good works, it's not going to work. And God warns us here. And we saw in verse 1 of chapter 9, of Revelation 9, where the star had fallen from heaven. That star that fell was Lucifer himself. In John the Apostle, there on the island of Patmos, remember we saw that in Revelation chapter 1, he's on the island of Patmos for the cause of Christ, for the gospel, and there Jesus is giving him this vision, this apocalypsis, revelation, unveiling of the things that will take place after this. That's Revelation chapter 1, verse 19. And we see here these seven letters, these seven trumpet judgments, a lot of sevens in Revelation, seven letters to seven churches, seven seal judgments, seven trumpet judgments, and then we'll see the seven bowl judgments. The seven, number seven means completion. It's going to be thorough. God isn't going to do a half job. He's going to fully bring about judgment on a Christ-rejecting world. And we pick it up, verse 2. It says, and he opened the bottomless pit. This is Satan. This is Lucifer, who was cast down. We saw it in our previous devotion, Isaiah chapter 14. And he opened the bottomless pit, and smoke arose out of the pit, like the smoke of a great furnace. So the sun and the air were darkened because of the smoke of the pit. Now listen, a few things here as we go through Revelation that we need to see is these trumpet judgments, especially the 5th, 6th, and 7th, now move from a physical judgment, a physical consequence, to now a spiritual consequence. You know, I think there's a lot of spiritual consequence in our world today. We forget that the spiritual realm is real. I think we forget that what God's word says about the spiritual realm, that God in his word means exactly what he says. Luke chapter 10, if you want to flip there a few pages to the left, Matthew, Mark, Luke, and John, Matthew, Mark, Luke. Jesus speaking to his disciples, Luke 10, verse 18, it says, and he said to them, I saw Satan fall like lightning from heaven. Behold, I give you the authority to trample on serpents and scorpions and over all the power of the enemy, and nothing shall by any means hurt you. You know, what authority, what protection the Lord has placed upon us. If you have been born twice, you only die once. If you are born of physical body, which if you're listening to this message, you are born of physical body. I don't think any robots are listening. If you're born a physical body, you're born, you're alive. God's giving you the breath of life. But then you need to be born again. You need to be born again, like Jesus said in John 3. If you're born twice, you will only die once. Right? 1 Corinthians 15, death has lost its sting over us. And Jesus there in Luke 10, verse 18, tells us he literally saw Satan fall like lightning from heaven. Just like we saw in Isaiah 14, like we saw at the beginning of Revelation chapter 9 there. And he says, I give you authority and none of it will hurt you. Verse 20, nevertheless, do not rejoice in this, that the spirits are subject to you, but rather rejoice because your names are written in the Lamb's book of life. You know, it's amazing that God has written our names in the Lamb's book of life. When you and I said yes to Jesus Christ, our names were written in the book of heaven that really determines whether we're going to heaven or we're going to move into a Christless eternity. And it's important we see that. Back in Revelation chapter 9, we see that it was Satan who Jesus saw fall from heaven. He's the one that opens the bottomless pit. Smoke arises. Just imagine the fear on the earth as this smoke arises. All of a sudden, it's like the most horror of horror movies. You're literally living in it. And this is that 7 years of tribulation. We do not want to be here for this. And it goes on, verse 3, then out of the smoke, locusts came upon the earth. And I believe these are demonic entities. And to them was given power, as the scorpions of the earth have power. It says, they were commanded not to harm the grass of the earth or any green thing or any tree. If you have your pen, underline this. But only those men who do not have the seal of God on their foreheads. So during this time, there'll be people taking the mark of the beast in their wrists, probably their foreheads. It'll be some sort of, they won't be able to buy or sell without it. Very likely it'll be some sort of chip for transactions, for tracking purposes. Even with this coronavirus, you could see what the benefits would be. They'll be able to quickly test your health functions, your blood pressure, those types of things to see if you have symptoms of coronavirus. And then they could order chip number 1472 to stay home and quarantine. But the Bible says there'll be those, even during the tribulation, probably friends and family of ours that may not receive Christ before the rapture, that will be left behind. And then during that 7 years of tribulation, we'll receive Jesus, we'll realize what we have shared with them, what God's word says to them is true, and they'll repent. It's important we see that, but I want you to see that this punishment even then will be on those who do not have the seal of God on their foreheads. You know, God has sealed you and I with the Holy Spirit of promise today. Even before the tribulation, we are sealed for Christ. God has already put his mark on you, almost like that movie Toy Story. The little boy writes his name on the bottom of the toy's foot. You know, the Lord has written his name on us. He bought and paid for us, the Bible says, with a price. And that price was his own body, his own blood. So know today, you are valuable to God. You belong to him. He loves you far more than you realize. And he'll keep you. And we don't have to be afraid of any of these things. We truly don't. Father, thank you today, Lord, that there is a spiritual realm around us. But Lord, your word says that, Father, you've written your name upon us. Lord, you've put your spirit within us. And that the authority, even today, that the demonic realm has, they do not have that authority over us. That he whom the Son sets free is free indeed. Lord, that we are no longer slaves of sin, to obey sin in its lust, but we are now slaves of righteousness. Lord, this new nature you've placed within us desires to serve you. Lord, desires to know you more. So Lord, today may we feed our spirit, Lord, and may we, Lord, put our flesh on a diet, Lord, that we may walk in the spirit and not fulfill the lust of the flesh today. You be glorified in us, we ask in Jesus' name, amen.